Hi, Zachary Vex of ZVexFX. We've got a few new products here at the 2015 NAMM, which is our 20th anniversary, by the way. Been in business since 1995. Here, this thing I'm cradling in my arms right now is called the Bomb Pop. It's got five effects in it: a Fuzz Factory 7, a Double Rock, a Lo-Fi Instant Lo-Fi Junkie, a Wah Probe, and last but not least, a Super Hard-On Boost. And what this does is, when you plug in here and take your out here, all of these are normalized into each other in this order: fuzz, distortion, modulation, wah, and boost. If you want to change the order, you just patch like a studio patch bay. For example, if you want to start with the instant lo-fi, you'd plug your guitar in here and then take the out and send it to whatever in you want and keep going in order until you're done with all the different pedals. The boost is always at the end, but these four, one, two, three, four, are all selectable. You can change the order. This will be made into a box that's not quite so thick. This prototype is very thick, but the production units will be about half the height. Bomb Pop. All right, next. The Woolly Mammoth 7. This is a 7-knob version of our original Woolly Mammoth that's got a Marshall tone stack, Marshall-style tone stack with bass, mid-range, and treble at the top. So now you have three tone controls instead of one. And also it has two different output volumes you can select with this switch right here. Going in the other direction price-wise, we have the Woolly Mammoth Fixture, which will be available in a few months. This will be a lower cost Woolly Mammoth compared to the relatively high cost of the hand-painted Woolly Mammoth right now. Here we have some elements of the ZVEX MIDI Light Show. This is a 4-watt mono headphone amp that could be used to send a click track to the drummer when you record your drums using the MIDI Light Show system. And the MIDI Light Show system consists of a couple of different pieces. If you come over here, you need at least one controller, and the controller can handle up to 8 dimmer bricks. And then you need as many dimmer bricks as you intend to have lights. So, and you can plug many lights into these dimmer bricks. They can handle up to 1,000 watts, conservatively. They could probably run 2,000 if you had to. You can plug the dimmer bricks into each other and daisy chain them if you're running low wattage light bulbs, and you have to use either halogens or tungstens. The tungstens that are still available are rough service bulbs, which are what you want so that you don't break the filaments when you're tossing your lights into your truck or your van. Now, a good place to put your lights are like inside your drums, perhaps inside your kick drum, or you can set lights up around the stage like living room lamps or desk lamps or bedroom lamps, clip lamps, or for more light, you can use those inexpensive halogens that are work lights that you could get at Home Depot or Menards or any other place that sells that kind of stuff. They cost very, very little and they're super bright. What you do to hook this thing up is, I have a 8-channel snake here. It's a hose, I think it's maybe $27. And I connect the 8-channel snake to the outputs of eight different outputs of this controller, and then go into 8 dimmer bricks. And the dimmer bricks are all connected together and plugged into the wall. And the dim outputs go to the individual light segments. Now in this case, if you look up there, I can play different segments, like that upper segment on the Z with the keyboard. To get started, once you've got it all hooked up to your MIDI system, you push one of these little buttons to tell it that it's going to learn its note, and then you press a note, and now it knows that that's the note associated with that light. You can make many lights go to the same note, or every single light can be a different note. And essentially, you play the lights as chords on the keyboard, in time with the band, and the band is playing to a click track. The drummer is playing to a click track, using that amplifier, the headphone amplifier over there. So this gives you an inexpensive way of getting into a relatively complex, pretty light show where you don't need a light man. All you need is a system where it's pre-recorded on a laptop. And so many people have their own laptop now. I can't think of a person I know who doesn't. And almost everybody I know has got Logic or Pro Tools or some other kind of MIDI outputting piano roll device. You can't do it, unfortunately, you can't do it with GarageBand because for some reason they crippled GarageBand and did not allow MIDI out. But any of the ones that do have MIDI out can be used with this. You can pre-record your lights and play them back with the drummer. You can split the headphone output on the computer so you're sending one side as a click track to the drummer and the other side to the front of house as fill-in backing tracks, strings, flutes, all kinds of fun stuff. So that's what we've got new here. ZVEX signing off.